It's been a long time since I've done a zombies top 5 or top 10. It's just not really my area of expertise, but I've got something pretty special for you guys. I'm going to do the top 10 worst zombie weapons in COD history, and this will not include any wonder weapons, and it's only going to be for Treyarch zombies, but the video has been written by my friend Elias. If you're familiar with Elias, he sends me emails all the time of detailed information about COD history stuff, guns, weapons, maps, history, everything, and he broke down his top 10 worst zombie weapons. So I am literally going to read what he gave me, and if you guys enjoy it, definitely drop a like. If I can figure out how to give him credit somewhere, I'll put it in the description. I thought it would be something fun to do and a little bit different. Let me know if you agree with his list or not. And as always, we are doing the monthly giveaway, PlayStation 4 to one lucky winner. Just drop a like, make sure you're subscribed, turn on those post notifications, and leave a comment why you want, actually, leave a comment what your favorite wonder weapon is in Call of Duty Zombies, and make sure to include your Twitter handle to enter. All right, let's get into this. At number 10, Elias has the NX Shadow Claws. He says, Black Ops 3 had some very good guns. They even brought back the fan favorite PPSH, but the Shadow Claw is the worst weapon in the game. Unlike the crossbow in Black Ops 1, this bow doesn't fire higher damage and it doesn't even distract the zombies at all. So he puts it all the way down at number 10 to kick off the list. At number 9, this is short and sweet, the ballistic knife. It was kind of crappy, he says, and it had weaker damage. The only reason why it's not higher is because when you actually upgrade it, you can use it to revive players. Therefore, it didn't move up the list, and that was the only sole reason that Elias had it ranked at number 9. And remember, this is no Wonder Weapons, and this is only Treyarch Zombies. No Advanced Warfare, no Infinite Warfare, no World War II. At number 8, the Mozu. Now, the worst revolver in Zombies history, according to Elias. Many players really want these revolvers to come back to Zombies as bullet weapons in the mystery box. And what happened with Black Ops 4 was a mini turd cannon. He says it's a very disappointing gun that had very weak damage. But what comes off to me is the mini turd cannon. I like it. I like the way he described it. At number 7, the PM63. Elias says, this SMG is easily one of the weakest weapons in Black Ops 1 Zombies. Now, SMGs are not good in Black Ops 1 Zombies, like the Spectre and the MPL, which is, he's saying those are going to be some dishonorable mentions instead of honorable mentions, so he's throwing them in the list. But he says the PM63 is the worst of all. The bullets will burst through ammo, run through ammo is what he means, and a pack-a-punch upgrade is easily one of the worst upgrades in this. It becomes a dual-wield SMG with horrible aiming. At number 6, the Essex Model 07. This weapon's real name is the Winchester Model 1895. Now, this piece of crap is considered the weakest weapon in Black Ops 4 as a whole. Even when you upgrade it, it's not that good. It's not the worst semi-auto wall weapon, he says, but it's not a very good starting weapon either. Cracking into the top 5, Elias has the War Machine. Now, this weapon's real name was the M32 MGL. And once again, he says this gun was a piece of crap. Unlike multiplayer, this gun shoots frag grenades. And the reason why it isn't number 1 on this list is because when you do finally pack-a-punch it, it actually becomes good. The one problem is that there's like 2 maps in Black Ops 2 that had PhD flopper, is what Elias says. Next up is the M1 Garand. This iconic World War II weapon appears in every single World War II Call of Duty game, Advanced Warfare, Black Ops 3, and Infinite Warfare. Now, it's referred to as the M1 Garand, not Garand. I've been saying it wrong for years. Many people referred to it as the other one, but John Garand, which is the creator of the M1 Garand, has the name John Garand. I'm still probably saying it wrong. Anyway, Elias says the gun is trash. Now, it's the same behavior as the M14, but here's the difference. The M1 Garand fires 8 round clips, and the M14 fires more. Now, the Black Ops 3 version is a little better, but the World at War version was very weak. At number 3, we all knew it was coming, the China Lake. So this gun is worse than the War Machine for a lot of big reasons, Elias says. At least the War Machine had better damage with Pack-a-Punch, despite there's no PhD flopper. However, the China Lake is even more weaker than the War Machine, even with PhD, it still sucks, and it earns the number 3 spot today. It's a bullpup weapon. Real name is Sarich Bullpup Rifle. This weapon was not only a weak weapon, but the bullet sprayed everywhere. He said it didn't have very good recoil. Also, the name of the Pack-a-Punch SMR is the SM1L3R Smiler. So maybe it can be a good gun with a happy name, but nope, Elias says it's trash. Somewhere we got mixed up with the numbers, but we're going to keep going. The Kar-98K. Now, the Carabiner 98 KERS, or short for the Kar-98K, is a German bolt-action rifle that was used in every single Call of Duty game and in Modern Warfare. The gun behaves like a knife in Zombies, where it's a one-shot kill in the head on round one, and then after that, it takes multiple shots. At least you can pack-a-punch it, but the problem is, it's the worst pack-a-punch weapon in COD Zombies. At number 2, the Arisaka. I hope I said that right. I probably didn't. This Japanese gun first appeared in World at War as the Type 99. And then it returned to Call of Duty World War II as a Type 38. And it's the same thing as the Kar-98K, except, guess what? You can't pack-a-punch this weapon. And at number 1 on Elias's list of the worst Call of Duty zombie weapons with no wonder weapons included, only Treyarch, is the Springfield. This gun appears in every single World War II Call of Duty game, and it was so bad that it takes 2-shot kills in round 1. This weapon only appears in Nocturne and Toten and Veruuk, so you can't even pack a punch the gun. It would have been interesting to see what this gun, the Springfield, would have been like if it was pack a punched. And there you have it. That is Elias's list. Let me know if you agree or disagree with him. Big shout out to him for always being so active with me on email. He's an awesome, awesome kid. And if you guys enjoyed this, it's a little different. Drop a like, make sure you're subscribed, and I'll see you soon.